Welcome, welcome to our fabulous Friday, last Friday in June social, where we are going to set up our July monthly journal. So welcome everyone. My name is Maya and I am a facilitator here at Silk and Sonder. And I am coming to you from Denver, Colorado, where we had a cooler day today. We'd had a few days in the 80s and today was a little bit cooler, probably only in the 70s. So it was a lovely, lovely end to the month of June. With me tonight is Bailey. She might pop on and wave. She will be, there she is, she's gonna give us a little wave. She will be keeping an eye on the chat. If you're having any problems, any questions, she'll be kind of helping if we need to kind of go back a slide. I have got lots and lots of examples for you to show you some different things that our Sonder fam have done. And I saw there was at least a few people in the chat saying that this is their first time joining a social and maybe even their first month. July is going to be their first month with Silk and Sonder. So how many people this is first set up social or first social at all that you've been to? You can just kind of throw like a little me in the chat. First time. Oh, awesome. Carol is here. Johanna is here. Oh, and now they're all starting to roll in. Jenny, Gretchen, lots of first timers. So welcome. So I will tell you that there's a lot of different ways to approach this, right? So first of all, the chat can get rolling really fast. We usually have a few hundred people with us. And so you can imagine a couple hundred people talking in a room gets a little overwhelming and that chat gets to rolling kind of quickly. Don't let that overwhelm you. So some people like to just kind of look at the chat, see what people are saying, watch the screen, listen to the music, and they take notes. Sticky notes are your best friend here, where you can kind of give yourself some notes in your journal, things that you know, what you might want to do with this, and then spend the time after the social to set up. Some people ignore the chat completely, which is absolutely fine. And they just focus on working on their journal, right? So absolutely no problem for you to do that. You can participate as little or as much as you want in the chat. Just know you aren't on camera and your microphones are not on. So you don't have to worry about any of that, right? So if there's kiddos or animals or something kind of in the background, you don't have to worry about any of that happening. So the other thing, make sure that you set your chat to everyone so that everyone here in the chat can see what you're saying. Otherwise, and it tends to default to the host and panelist, especially if you're on an iPhone or an iPad. So if it only says host and panelist, then that means only Bailey and myself will have seen it. So if you're ever typing something and you think like, oh my gosh, nobody's commenting on, you know, my ideas or thoughts, it might be because you have it set to host and panelist, right? So make sure that you flip that. Let's see what else. Oh, also sometimes if you're on a phone or an iPad and you have the chat open, the music won't play or you can't hear the sound. So just know that those are kind of some little glitchy things with Zoom that you kind of have to work around just a little bit. Yeah, and I see Steph is saying there's no journal police. Yes, absolutely. None of us are going to show up at your door and knock and ask to see your journal and give you a demerit if something's not done or tell you you have to do things a certain way. Always remember that this journal is there for you to do what you need at that time. And sometimes our needs are different, right? Months are different, days sometimes are different. So really allow yourself to do what you need. If you see something somebody else did and you think, oh, mine doesn't look as good as that, or I wish I would have done that. There's always next month, right? Like our opening song said, promise of a new day. Every day is a new day. We get a new month, we get new weeks. We have lots of new opportunities to kind of shake things up and change things around. So just a few little housekeeping rules, just some community guidelines. We want to make sure that you know that this is a safe and supportive space. So we ask that you're kind and courteous to both yourself and to others. No promotions or spam, respecting everyone's privacy, even if you happen to know people in real life, they're here in the chat. What happens here in our Sonder social stays. So we don't violate anyone's privacy. If you have product questions or accessory questions. And I see some people are kind of talking about using the Frixen erasable pens. That's absolutely fine. It's just, we don't necessarily want the whole chat to be taken up with accessory questions. The best place to ask that is in Sonder Club, because then you can get lots of good recommendations from folks there. So hopefully everyone is on our app, our Sonder Club app, and kind of checking in there so that you can, it's a great place to post if you have questions or you want to get some ideas from our other members. Also, if you have any customer care inquiries like shipping or billing or, you know, something like that, we ask that you send an email to hello@silkandsonder.com. Neither Bailey nor I, we're not in the back end of the business, right? We're not in headquarters. And so we can't look you up and we can't, you know, see any of that kind of stuff. So any of those kinds of questions need to go to that hello@silkandsonder. And they are a Monday through Friday, you know, kind of a 9 to 5 on the West Coast time zone. So they will get back to you as quickly as possible. And of course, we've got a holiday weekend coming up. So there's going to probably be a little bit of a lag sometimes with some of those questions. So we just ask that you're patient. And remember, ultimately, these socials are a tool to help you elevate your emotional health through the power of community. But ultimately, you're responsible for your own emotions, well-being, and decisions. So if there's ever an activity that we're working on that maybe doesn't resonate with you, or maybe it's triggering, or maybe it's too stressful, or you don't want to think about it, you can just kind of sit back, listen to the music, you can color, you can doodle, you can wait until we get to another section, right? Just let yourself do what you need to do. Again, this is for you. This isn't for anybody else. You're not getting graded. You're not getting a demerit if you don't do something correctly, right? There's no wrong way to Sonder, right? This is you and what works for you. So just keep that in mind. So this month, the theme is acceptance, which is kind of an interesting, when I first saw that, I thought, gosh, I don't even know what to make of that, right? Like, what do we, acceptance? Like, you know, how is that going to play out for this month? So I always like to tell people the first thing I do when I get my journal is I turn to page 2 and I read Meha's letter to us. And it's so fun because it's kind of this little peek into her life. Meha is our founder and she's the one who came up with this. And she really, really wants, you know, things to be, this journal to be a source of support for us. And she writes these little letters about the theme. And so it's been really kind of eye-opening sometimes to read her letters. So if you haven't given yourself the treat of sitting down and reading this letter, highly recommend it. So just a few things, you know, I kind of want to touch on that she talks about. First of all, we're halfway through the year, which you probably know, but that's, you know, that's okay. But yep, July is the halfway mark. And that acceptance is a layered, nuanced, and mature thing. And it's also a never-ending journey to learn how to fully accept ourselves and our circumstances, right? And I love that it's acceptance is its own kind of roller coaster ride. Both Bailey and I are big Disney fans and we love going on roller coasters, but sometimes acceptance isn't always the roller coaster ride that we want to be on, right? But it's very, very important for us to, Bailey even found a roller coaster emoji to pop in the chat. I love it. But acceptance can be hard, right? It can be frustrating. And sometimes that inner 3-year-old, doesn't want to accept things the way they are and kind of throws a little bit of a tantrum. And so really that idea of learning to accept things, that doesn't mean you don't try to change them, not at all. And it doesn't mean you have to like them, right? But acceptance is important for us to be able to continue growing, right? And then she also talks about what she's come to understand is that it's easier to find things to connect on when you release yourself of all judgment. So connecting with others and other situations when you can kind of release that judgment. And I love the last little paragraph. She kind of pushes us a little bit. Bailey and I were kind of talking about this. So this month, when you feel that ounce of judgment towards yourself, your partner, a friend, a colleague, a child, or a situation you're in, she encourages us to pause and ask ourselves whether we're practicing true acceptance, right? Embrace those imperfections, find gratitude in the moment, and feel the release when you accept people for who they are, circumstances for what they are, and most importantly, your whole self for what it is. And I just love that. And it can be hard, right? I'm not saying it's easy. I still myself am learning new things about myself and learning new things to accept. But the more we can think about that, the more we can practice that, and we're going to have a whole month to practice it. So hopefully you'll also join us on our weekly setups, because we're going to dig deeper into this theme of acceptance. Every week we will have a different area. We call it mind mapping. And each week we will kind of dig into that, a different area of our lives where we're going to practice acceptance. So please join us if you can. And we'll kind of continue this acceptance journey together. So here's our agenda for tonight. We're going to do a little acceptance opening activity. We're going to reflect on the month of June. We're going to set our July intentions. We're going to set up our mood tracker, and we're going to set up our habit tracker. And I always use these little cartoons to remind us that there is room for you here just as you are. If everything is going great, you are like hitting home runs right and left, everything is great, job, relationships are good, things are going great, tell us about it. We love to celebrate things with you. That's what we're here for, right? Conversely, if things aren't going so well, maybe you've been hitting some bumps in the road. We have folks who have lost jobs. We have folks who are in a job that they don't like. People who maybe haven't been feeling well, people who have family who have been ill, people who have lost family members or friends. We're here for you too. We are here to support you. So don't ever feel like, oh, I just kind of, I am having these kind of bad things happening. Life is really kind of bumpy for me right now, but I don't want to bring anybody down. So I don't want to share that in the chat, right? Don't think like that, right? Again, life is a whole series of ups and downs, right? And so be sure that you don't feel that you can't share the good or you can't share the bad. We're here for everything. We're here for all of it, right? Same thing with the other little cartoon where it says the way you feel matters, and so many, and no emotion you feel is bad or unworthy, right? So no one can tell you how you should feel about something, right? Your feelings are your feelings, and kind of sitting with those and thinking about them is very, very important to that idea of self-discovery and acceptance, right? So we're here to feel the feels, good feels, bad feels, indifferent feels, all those different things, right, as we move forward. So let's start with this opening activity here. And I loved this sentence, this phrase, acceptance is the first step toward change, right? And you might be thinking, wait a second, I thought acceptance was saying like, I'm okay with how things are. It's not, right? Acceptance is saying like, okay, this is how things are. I'm going to accept that. And that's the first step towards changing, which kind of does sound a little, opposite, but it really is, because if you can't accept how things are, then you won't be able to really see them how they are, and you won't be able to change. So what we want you to do is to find a blank page in your July journal. Or maybe you want some scratch paper. Your July journal hasn't gotten here yet, so you want some scratch paper, or you want to do this on some scratch paper and transfer it in later. Absolutely fine. Maybe you have one of our thoughts journals, so you kind of want to, put it in there. Whatever, again, whatever works for you. And what I want you to do is to think about an obstacle in your path that's keeping you from a goal, right? Is there something you can do to move the obstacle or to work with it? How can you accept the current state to get where you want to be? What can it look like this month if you work on this obstacle? So this is just kind of a chance for you to free write, answer these questions, and I'll show you what I did for mine. So I wrote at the top of the paper, acceptance is the first step toward change. And I happened to come across, as I was working on this, a quote from Elizabeth Gilbert, who's the woman who wrote Eat, Pray, Love, which I have not read, and I haven't seen the movie either. Shh, don't tell anybody. I know of it. But this quote, she says, I've never seen any life transformations that didn't begin with the person in question finally getting tired of their own beep. Right. I hope I don't offend any. That's her quote, right? With the naughty word in there, right? And I think that's really true, right? Life transformations, we have to, we kind of get tired of our own stuff, right? But we have to accept it first, right? And so my goal this year is to really declutter my house. Now, I don't want to be a minimalist. Like, I don't want to go to that extreme. But we've lived here about 21 years. And when you live in a place for a long time, now I understand why people move frequently, because you can't collect a lot of stuff if you're constantly moving. Although I bet there's some people who could challenge me and say, I move every 4 years and I have even more stuff, you know, all the time. Megan's saying, I was going to ask how to use this for decluttering. So here you go. So my obstacle, my big obstacle when I kind of think about it is often it's my thoughts. It's my own mindset, right? So see if any of these sound true. I think, well, what if I need it later? What if someone else needs it? What if someone needs, I was going to save this for someone, I'm saving it for something. Maybe I might want it, or I paid X amount of dollars for this, right? I hate to just throw it away. I hate to just donate it. I paid a lot of money for this. I hate to just throw it away, but I like it. It brings back memories. I don't have time to work on the house. I don't have time to declutter. And it's overwhelming because, you know, it is. You start looking at things big picture and it gets overwhelming. So as I'm sitting here thinking about acceptance, and this is definitely something I'm going to work through the whole month on, but I realized if I want a more peaceful environment, I need less stuff. And I just have to accept that. Right. Oh, the good boxes. Yeah. Right, Carly, you've got to save the good boxes. You might need it to make. You don't. And one of the ways to kind of think about this, so I wrote, yes, I do have a lot of cool stuff. However, my house is just one size and I'm not moving and I'm not going to go to a storage facility, right? I can limit what I bring in and I can donate those things that I need to let go of. I realize I need more of an abundance mindset. Also think of the river. There was someone who wrote about a river analogy, right? Where things come and go and I can reach in, pick up what I need or let things go down the river because other things are going to come by. I'm not missing out. I'm not never going to be able to get that thing again. It's just kind of flowing through. So this was kind of my thought process as I was working on this. And I think there's probably more as I kind of think on it, but I have been for those of you who are with us a lot, we're redoing our bedroom and that definitely has spurred a lot of like, I've got to get rid of this stuff. It's so peaceful to have a room with not a lot of stuff in it. Right. And I know a lot of people kind of go through that. So what I'm going to do, I'll put it back on this. So you can kind of see the prompt and I'll show you mine again, if you want to see that, but I'm going to play a little bit of music. Right. And I'm going to let you work on yours. Your goal may be something totally different. Maybe your goal is finding a new job. Maybe it is moving. Any many, many different goals. So please feel free to share with us if you'd like in the chat, what's your goal and what's the obstacle in your path? And if you can't think of the obstacle, right? You're like, this is my goal. I can't quite get it done. I'm not sure what the obstacle is. Really kind of think about that. Be like, why can't I do this, right? What is the problem? Oftentimes I will say it's our mindset is not letting us, right? So work on that. Feel free to share as much or as little as you would like in the chat. And we'll check back in here in just a few moments. goodness. Thank you all so much for being so vulnerable in the chat, talking about these goals and really doing some deep digging to think about those obstacles, right? Wanting to travel, but your family, spouse don't want to go the places you want to go. So thinking like a goal would be, I would travel alone, but like the obstacle is like, that's scary, right? What does that feel like to travel by yourself? What if I get lost? What if I don't have anybody to talk to? What if I feel lonely, right? Kind of thinking of all these things, wanting to find a new job, but feeling in a new career, but feeling guilty that you're leaving your coworkers behind, right? So again, kind of putting some pressure on yourself to be making other people's lives, better. And it's like, how is that helping? I definitely see lots of people have the decluttering thing on there. And there are lots of really great, there's lots of different great Facebook groups. There's good Facebook groups for people who want to travel alone, women who want to travel alone. They have lots of good suggestions. Just lots of these different places. And acceptance can be really hard. I mean, that's the other thing. You're not going to accept this and work through all of this in the time we're going to be sitting here working on our journal, right? This is going to be a lengthy process. So again, give yourself some time, but really look at kind of what you wrote. And I'll bring you back to this when we get to the habits tracker, and I'll show you what I did to kind of help me with this, with the obstacle, right? To kind of put some action steps in place. So again, don't abandon this after today, but keep this kind of, spend some time writing this down and spend some time looking back at it each, maybe each day, maybe each week, and really kind of thinking about those obstacles, right? And what can you do to accept and then push those obstacles out of the way? All right. So excellent work there, kind of starting that process. And it's a big process. Again, like I said, you're not going to fix it in a 90 minute session or, you know, however long, right? All right. So you've got that. And I think that's a good place to kind of start as we start to think about some of these other pieces in our July monthly planner. So the first thing that we do is our reflections, reflect back on the month of June. And this is so, so, so important. Sometimes I always want to rush past this and like jump straight into July. But it's like, we really need to think about that this month that has just passed. And we're going to think about our wins for the month, our challenges, our favorite moments, and maybe what do I want to start, stop, and continue. So this is going to be on page 8. Right? And wins are something that you did that made you smile, maybe made you happy. It was some sort of an accomplishment, could be big or small, just any of those kinds of wins. So for example, I had put on my June wins, started decluttering with vigor, right? I actually did get rid of a box of yarn someone had wanted. So I have a lot of yarn. I saw someone was talking about craft supplies. I have a lot of yarn. But I sold a box of yarn to someone who's going to be very happy to have it. I put a box of clothes. There's a website called Thread Up where you can send your clothes in and they give you credit to potentially get other clothes. They don't give you a ton of credit, but they give you a little bit. So maybe you can feel like you're not, kind of losing that money. So that felt good. June, my birthday was in June. And so I used a bunch of the birthday treats and I kind of kept track of, when you get the little emails, all the different things you sign up and they give you send you an email for a free cookie or a free pizza, or I got a free bag of bird seed at, the bird food store. Oh, thanks, Donna. So that was definitely a win. So our challenges are something that maybe didn't go right, something out of our control, maybe a stumbling block, a frustration. Painting our bedroom was definitely a challenge. We scraped the popcorn ceiling. Such a challenge, right? So think about those challenges. And then the favorite moments are just that. And sometimes your wins are your favorite moments, but my June, now you guys are all going to argue about who to send yarn to. June favorite moments. I went to my best friend, her daughter graduated from high school. So I went to that. I had dinner with my nephew. So all those different kind of favorite moments. And so if you're not sure, you can look back. If you've been with us for a while, you can look back at your rosebud and thorn from those weekly spreads. Oh, that should say in June. And then you can also use your phone to review maybe your calendar or pictures. I love to go back through my pictures for the month and kind of see it. A lot of times I'm surprised at the things that I did. I'm like, oh yeah, I forgot I did that. Oh yeah, I forgot I did that. And then that start, stop, and continue. So think about that goal. Think about that obstacle. And now start thinking about what are some things that you want to start, right? Things that aren't being done, but you want to, things to begin doing to get better results, things that are worth trying or maybe experimenting with this month. So I need to start doing a 10K race in January. I used to do a lot of those half marathons and 10Ks, and then I kind of got out of the habit. But we'll be doing a Disney race in January. And I was only able to sign up for the 10K because the half marathon went so fast, which probably was a good thing. But I'm going to plan for my 10K training and start doing that, right? That's my July start. And then stop things that aren't working, things that aren't helping, things that impede or are not practical, things that aren't delivering those desired results, things you don't like, things that don't serve you. That's another thing. Have you ever noticed sometimes that we do things just because that's what we've always done and we realize it's not really serving us anymore? Those are the things we're going to stop. And continue are things that are working well, things you want to keep, things you want to, things to continue to see if they're worthwhile, maybe things that you like or things that you need, any of those kinds of things. And so you don't have to use your goal and challenge that, and obstacles that you just thought of, but I think that would be maybe a good start to kind of think about that for this section. So I'm going to play you a little bit of music, let you work on this. Feel free to share whatever you would like from this page. And we'll check back in here in just a moment. If I can find my mouse, it's being very obnoxious. Where did it go? There it is. All right. Okay, I think everybody is going to go take a dancing class now. I love, love, love all the people saying that they went to different dance classes and going to recitals and learning tap dance and doing salsa dancing and those kinds of things. That's amazing. I love that. And that's what's so great about these socials. It's really kind of getting these ideas from other people, kind of seeing what other folks are doing, seeing things that people are, you know, really enjoying and things that people are wanting to stop doing, right? And then you can kind of look and go, oh, I thought I was the only one who did that, but oh my gosh, other people do that too. So this is, I always think it's very important to not skip these reflections and to not skip this, what you want to start, stop, and continue as you move forward into planning for what you want to do for this month. So I found this quote, which I thought was also kind of nice with this idea of acceptance, right? We do not grow absolutely chronologically. We grow sometimes in one dimension and not in another, unevenly. We grow partially. We are relative. We are mature in one realm, childish in another. The past, present, and future mingle and pull us backward, forward, or fix us in the present. We are made up of layers, cells, and constellations. And I really love this quote because, you know, sometimes you think growth is supposed to be linear, right? And you can't take a step back or you can't take a you know, sidebar or a bird walk or whatever, right? But really this quote really kind of drives that home, right? We don't grow absolutely chronologically. We don't grow on this linear path. Sometimes there's an area where we grow a lot and there's another area where we don't grow at all. And at any given point in time, we're both childish and mature, right? And so kind of dealing with those complex emotions can definitely be something that's tricky. So kind of a fun little quote to kind of help remind us that as we're growing, to give ourselves some grace, right? And to know that everything's not, we're not on a challenge. It's not a timeline. Again, nobody's going to come knocking on the door and check and make sure that we're growing in a particular way, right? So let's set those July intentions. Let's think about the intentions that we want to go into this month with. So that's over on page 9. And these are the areas that we give you. You can always cross them out and come up with your own areas of your life if something makes more sense. For example, we have one of our facilitators is retired and she always crosses out professional goals and she changes it to learning goals. I've also seen people change it to creativity goals, right? Same thing with any of these, right? If there's one, some people say that they feel like personal life and key relationships are kind of the same thing. So they switch it up. I changed for this month, I changed personal life to home environment. So again, so I can kind of keep chipping away at those obstacles that keeps me from having that more clutter-free home. So lots of different ways that you can approach this page. You can use that theme of acceptance to set your intentions. You can focus in on one area like self-love or self-talk, things that you would say to yourself in these particular areas of your life. Maybe you want to use song lyrics or quotes from someone that kind of inspire and capture that intention that you want for that area. You really want to think about how you want to feel this month in each area. Maybe words aren't enough. And so you want to use stickers or you want to use colors or images, doodles. Maybe you want to, in each one of these areas, think about one thing you want to let go of, maybe something you want to stop and something you want to start doing in each of these areas. So this is what it looks like, right? On page 9. So here are a lot of different examples of things that folks have done. Notice they have maybe just one word and some pretty colors. Person on the right has some fun stickers that they've used. Oh, the other thing that I was going to tell you is a lot of times folks will take a screenshot or take a picture with their camera of some of these slides so that they can go back and look at them again later. And I will kind of scroll through these as we're playing the music as you work on this section. So don't feel like you're not going to see it again. It will come back because I know sometimes you're like, wait, I wanted to see it, that one example again. And again, some different examples, things like remember the strength that lies within yourself. So they have some quotes. The one in the middle is one that I did when the theme was imagine, right? And so I put things like imagine relaxation, imagine endurance, imagine connection, imagine abundance, imagine inspiration. Again, the other, another person used, they had some cool stickers. Sometimes I don't know where y'all get your cool stickers. Unlocking clarity under money management, right? Inspiring creativity and professional goals. And I liked, there was a, another quote that I liked about how intentions are gentler, and they don't imply you've been doing something wrong all this time and will now be determined to do something good. This isn't about like, I've been bad and now I'm going to be good. This is about how you want to go into the month of July in these particular areas. So I love the one with the little kitty cats. Of course, I love their little expressions and the little snuggly kitty cats there for the key relationships. Another one, they use some pretty washi tape to kind of decorate and just put simple things like tracking spending, prayer and meditation, enjoying the journey, appreciate, knowledge sharing, right? Those different kinds of ideas. We've got another one with some fun Disney stickers, right? So they, again, found some fun Disney stickers and then kind of wrote some different things around each one. I love the one in professional goals where it says, always be kind. And then they say, assume more positive intent, bring fun. It's okay to pause and take a beat, right? Super cute. The one in the middle, they did some fun little doodles, a little more creative than what I have, what I do. I usually just write something, but those are lovely. And then the other thing that is good sometimes to do is put it on a post-it note, because sometimes, and I do this too, I'll write things down and then I'm like, oh, I wanted to say that better. And then you want to scribble it out and then you feel like you're kind of making a mess and now you don't have any more room. So using post-it notes can be super helpful, right? And so like, for example, I wrote in my physical health, I wrote, I accept the fact that if I want to be able to do all the things I want to do as I get older, I need to take more care of my body, do more movement, eat more nutritious foods, do stretching, etc. Right? So again, I accept the fact that if I want to be able to do these things, I need to do these other things, right? So again, kind of, I tried to frame these with the theme of acceptance. So I'll kind of scroll through these. So again, you can look at these examples. Feel free to let us know your intentions in any of these areas, or if you're changing anything up, if you've maybe switched up one of the categories to something else. And you don't have to fill out every single one, right? If you feel like you really want to focus on one area for this month, you can totally focus on one area. That's absolutely okay, right? And just leave the others blank. I know it sounds horrible to leave something blank in your journal, but you really can, I promise, right? So take a few moments, fill that out. We'll check back in here in just a moment. All right. How'd you do? I saw lots of good ideas for different things, to kind of put, to put in there, this idea of, Bailey's using alliteration. So she's everything's M with the M. So spiritual meditation, personal life motivation, physical movement, key relationships, meaningful money management, mindfulness, and professional manifest. So I love that's a fun way to do it, right? Absolutely. And good point about how this really isn't another to-do list, right? We have plenty of other places for to-do lists on here. This really is a place for you to again, to kind of set that intention. And then you can set your to-do list from those intentions. So hopefully you've got kind of a good idea for what you want to do moving forward. And then we'll flip over to our mood tracker. I do want to mention that usually we do try to remind you during the weekly setups to look back at your July intentions. I think what happens with a lot of us is we spend a lot of time doing this and then we forget to look back on it for the rest of the month. So we will try to remind you to look back at these intentions, but you can also put that in maybe as a habit or in some of your to-dos is to look back at your intentions on a regular basis and think, are these still serving me? Does this really encapsulate what I want to do? And you can always change them, right? So our mood tracker over on page 10. So this is a good place to really help us understand those trends and how we're feeling. Maybe we can notice something that's going on and make some shifts. We can bring some tools into what works when those positive moods show up for us. So some different ways that people set this up. Maybe you choose 2 to 3 negative feelings, 1 neutral feeling, and 2 to 3 positive feelings. Focus on acceptance for this month. You could focus on, something that a mood that would indicate some sort of acceptance. You can fill in when you go to fill it in. You can fill in every emotion that came up that day, or fill in whatever emotion was strongest. One of the things I had to do is I noticed, I go through a whole gamut of emotions during the day, and the thought of trying to track all the moods that I go through during the day felt a little too much. And so what I do is I have an alarm on my watch that goes off at noon to remind me to take my noon supplements. And so when it goes off, then I also did a little habit stacking, right? And so I take my supplements and I track the mood that I'm feeling right then. So I have this nice little wheel of the mood that I had at noon every day, right? So that's one way that you could potentially do it. You could also, again, like I said, some people like to track multiple. Some people just kind of track an overall sense for the day. You can use stickers or colored pens or doodles, or just a regular old pen to create your key, kind of like what that means. So, and I'll leave it on this. And when we cycle through, I'll cycle through this, the moods wheel, the emotion wheel here, so you can kind of see. But there's lots of different words. So maybe if you're like, okay, I don't want the word sad, but I want something that kind of encapsulates that, you can kind of look through here and find something, find a new emotion or something maybe a little bit deeper, something a little more targeted that you want to take a look at. So here's some examples. And Bailey's also popping in a link to one of our blog posts that has the how to use the mood tracker and has that feelings wheel in there. And I do want to point out, because sometimes people ask, you'll notice sometimes in our journal, we have the little hexagons for the mood tracker, and then sometimes we have the wheel. So the hexagon is for months with 30 days or fewer. So February, and then the other months with 30 days. If the month has 31 days, then you get the circle. So just so you know, if a month is coming up that's going to only have 30 days, then know that it's going to be the hexagons. And if it's 31, you're going to have the circles. So I know we have kind of a team circle, team hexagon thing going on. Some people like the hexagons better, some like the circles. But this month we've got our circle friend back. So here's some examples of how some people use it. The person over on the right, they kind of came up with all the different words that would encapsulate some of those different feelings, and they're kind of going to track it that way. The one in the middle, you notice they changed it to a book tracker, and they actually decided they wanted to track which book they were reading on which day. So the key is the different books that they were reading and how which days they spent reading those books. Some people get very, very colorful. And I love that and get very creative too with repurposing, right? So the one on the left is looking at, it says purpose fuels passion, and it's the different kinds of things that they did to maybe educate or do a group post or invite. So the things that they were doing in their social media, and they kind of tracked what they did there. Or then the person on the right was tracking different kinds of work. Oh, awesome. We have one of our, is it Lainey? I'm probably pronouncing your name wrong. Believe me, as a person whose name Maya, I probably have, I know all about having your name pronounced wrong. But we do, Leanne, thank you. Thank you, Leanne, for sharing that, because we really do have real life Sonderfam examples up there. So we love it when you feel like sharing and you want to share. We always put those up here. So we've got some exercise things that people are tracking. Here's some other moods and how they did that with the colors, right? They have happy, anxious, sentimental, depressed, romantic, and crabby. I love the crabby one. That's fun. Maybe not fun to feel crabby, but that's kind of a fun word to have in there. Another person using it, reading is my jam. I'm not sure if they were tracking minutes reading or pages, but they've got kind of those numbers in there that they're tracking, and they're going to track it with the little flower stickers. Other ways to repurpose, some people use it to write in their daily affirmations, track anxiety levels, depression levels. They do it maybe on a scale of 1 to 5 for one specific feeling. So angry, tired, joyous, and then they just kind of track that one emotion, how intensely they felt that emotion for the month each day. Here's one to track anxiety levels. And this can be really helpful, again, when you're kind of looking back and kind of seeing what this looks like. We've got panic, high, moderate, scattered, low, and none. And again, I'll cycle through these as you work on them. This one I is mine, and I did to track different ways of learning, different modalities of learning that I did. And so, oops, sorry. So here's our circle, right? I'll cycle through these. Let us know what moods you're tracking or how you're repurposing it. And we'll check back in here in just a moment. All right. So hopefully you've got some ideas for how you want to use this. Again, you can repurpose it for something, use it to track those moods. It took me a long time to really figure out how to track the moods. I used to like not, I was like, this isn't working for me. But like I said, when I set the alarm on my watch and kind of tied it with that, that really helped me figure out when to kind of track. And it is kind of interesting sometimes to see, you can detect a pattern. We even had one woman who talked about how her husband had said something about, you're always mad or you're always upset or something. And she's like, no, I'm not, looking at my mood tracker. I can show you, here's the days where I was happy. Here's the days where I felt joy. Here's the day, right? So she actually had that data to kind of show him. And then he had to kind of back off because she had that in front of her, right? So it's kind of nice to have that to look back, because you know how we go to extremes, right? I'm always angry. I'm always sad. I'm always frustrated. You look back at this sometimes and you're like, oh, okay, that's not really true. I'm not always that way. All right. So last one we're going to work on here is our habit tracker, right? So habit tracker is good. It's over on this next page, page 11. And we can maybe start doing some new habits. We can have it for stop things. So like stop habits that don't serve us, or things that we want to continue. Maybe we want to use acceptance as our focus. Maybe pick some sort of a theme that we want to go with, continue our habits from last month. I definitely recommend finding a balance between ones you know you can do and ones that are going to be a little bit trickier or harder to commit to. So don't come up with seven brand new habits for this. That's going to be way too much. That'll be a little too frustrating, right? So kind of think about maybe some things that you're already doing. And really, this one is more for a thing you want to do every day. And the weekly ones are more for things that are specific to the week and maybe that you only want to do a few times each week, right? So that's kind of the difference between those two. So again, think about those obstacles that you listed in our opening activity. Maybe there's some habits that might help you accept and overcome that obstacle, and you don't have to fill in every single line. So here's some examples. And again, what I'll do is I'll scroll through these as you work on them, but different ways people fill them out. I do like to highlight, like this person did, they highlighted the weekends, because it's always kind of interesting to me. Sometimes I'll look and I'll be like, oh, the days that I don't do this are the weekends. So clearly this is not a weekend habit for me, but oftentimes that's okay, right? So not a big deal. Here is mine that I set up actually for this month with that idea of my goal and my obstacle being like the clutter and my mindset. So I did add in reflection, give myself some time to reflect and kind of think on my thoughts. And then also intentional spending only, although I still need to define what intentional means to me. And then spend 15 minutes of decluttering, right? And also I put in here, track my small wins. I've been starting to try to do that because sometimes I feel like I never get anywhere. But if I track those small wins, I can actually see that I am making progress sometimes, like getting rid of the box of yarn, right? And then you can see the one over here on the right, they put four things in and they're only tracking four things, right? And really think about, does this habit still serve me, or am I blindly following an old routine? Am I just doing the thing that I always did, right? Here's some other examples of some other habit trackers that folks have used, different kinds of things that they have popped in there. Very, very beautiful ways to track. Yeah, Megan, absolutely steal the small win thing. It's been working really nicely. Again, different ways to do to track, or just kind of scribble out like the person did on the bottom when those days were ones that they didn't track. There's some examples of small habits for self-love that you could potentially use. Some more examples. I told you I have lots and lots of examples, right? And then we also have like this little habit tracker idea. So again, I'm going to play a short little song and we'll check back in. Let us know what habits you want to track for this month, and we'll see how things go there. Thank you. Okay. So hopefully you've got an idea for some habits that you want to do for this month. Got some ideas for how to kind of set things up. And I did want to leave you with, a lot of people ask, what can we do with our the sleep tracker, right? Like, I already have something that tracks my sleep, or I don't need to track sleep at all. What can I do with this page? So here's some different ideas of things that people have done. They've used it as a cleaning log, a bingo list, a learning log, books that they've read, workout, work breaks, things that they've done to take a break. So lots of different fun ideas for how to go through and set that up. So hopefully you've gotten a really good start on setting up your month. Know that there are lots of other socials that we do. We will have a social working on that wheel of life that's there at the beginning, because that's something we have usually every quarter. So we have a social for that. We have socials for some of the different journal prompts that are in there to kind of go through. We have those weekly setups. So please feel free to join us for those so that we can make sure everything makes sense to you. Again, we give you lots of ideas, but we love to hear your ideas. These are all ideas from Sonder Fam, right? So we love to kind of see what everyone is doing with their planner. So if you share your planner, if you feel compelled to, there's no pressure, right? You don't have to, but share your planner there with us in Sonder Club so we can take a look. So believe it or not, that's the end of our time together, right? We do have a couple QR codes. We still have the refer a friend program going, where if you refer a friend, they get $10, you get $10. You should get a link in your email about a survey that you can fill out to kind of talk about the socials, what you want to see more of, what kinds of things you'd like. I know a lot of people want a book club. So they put that in the survey. So I know they're thinking about that, kind of trying to figure out that logistically. And then also Bailey is going to pop in the chat the YouTube link. So all of our socials are recorded. They are posted on a private YouTube channel. And make sure that you bookmark or save the link, because you can't search it. You can't just go to Silken Sonder's website to find it. You have to actually go through the link. Oftentimes we will pop that in Sonder Club so people can find it. We have over 500 recordings up there now. So you can always find it. If you miss a weekly, you can always find either the correct weekly or a past weekly, because they're essentially the same. Same thing with monthly, kind of going through. You can see some of the different opening activities that we've done. You can watch all of those. That's all part of your membership. So thank you all so, so much for joining us here. I will post a link to my Spotify playlist, if I can find it here. I didn't play all the songs, but there's lots of fun songs in there if you like to listen to some of the instrumentals. And thank you all so much for joining us. It's so nice to be able to spend some time with you, really kind of setting things up as we go through this new month with the theme of acceptance. So let's see how that plays out. All right. Take care, everyone. Have a great weekend, and we will hopefully see you soon.
Do you ever feel like a plastic bag drifting through the wind, wanting to start again? Do you ever feel so paper thin, like a house of cards, one blow from caving in? Do you ever feel already buried deep, 6 feet under screens, but no one seems to hear a thing? Do you know that there's still a chance for you? There's a spark in you, you just gotta ignite the light and let it shine just on the night, like the 4th of July. 'Cause baby, you're a firework. Come on, show them what you work. Make them go as you should have.